हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। वेलकम बैक टू अवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल सिचुएटेड एट गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। दिस इज़ योर साइंस टीचर। सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम हियर विथ एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 11, वाटर। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर you had learned about sources of water, storage of water, drinking water and saving water. Now students, let's come to the exercises based on this chapter. Let's remember, answer the following questions orally. So students, here you have to answer the following questions orally. Name three sources of water. So students, the sources, three sources of water are rainwater, rivers and lakes. Now let's come to the question number second. Is water from lakes fit for drinking? No. Water from lakes is not fit for drinking. Because water from lakes may not always be clean. Now let's come to the third question. How should we store drinking water? So students, to store drinking water, you should store clean water in closed container. How can we kill germs in the drinking water? So students, by boiling the drinking water, we kill germs in the drinking water. Now students, here two keywords are given: rainwater. The water we get from rain is called rainwater. The second keyword is groundwater. The rainwater that seeps into the ground is known as groundwater. Now students, let's read the summary of this chapter. Water is used for drinking, cooking, bathing, cleaning, washing and many other things. So my dear students, as you know that we use water for many purposes like drinking, cooking, bathing, cleaning, washing and many other things. Rainwater fills ponds, lakes, streams and rivers. The rainwater that seeps into the ground is known as groundwater. So students, this is the definition of groundwater. We dig wells and hand pumps to get groundwater. So students, to get groundwater, we dig wells and hand pumps. Drinking dirty water can make us ill. We should keep clean water in closed containers. We should not waste water. Now, let's come to the exercises. Question number A. Write T for true and F for the false statement. We get water from rain. So this statement is true. So here you have to write T. We can use groundwater by digging wells. This statement is also true. So here you have to write tea. We should drink water directly from lakes and rivers. So this statement is false, because water from lakes and rivers may not always be clean. Sure? So this statement is false. You have to write F. Dirty water does not contain germs. So students, dirty water always contains germs. So this statement is false. You have to write F. Let's come to the fifth statement. We should store clean drinking water in open containers. This statement is also false, because we should store clean drinking water in closed containers. Now let's come to the question number B. Choose the correct option. Which of the following activities need water? Your options are bathing, reading, washing clothes, or both A and C. So students, we need water for bathing and washing clothes. So here our answer will be option number D, both A and C. Let's come to the second one. Which of these is not a source of water? So students, as you know that lake, river and canal are source of water. So here the option number C, park, is not a source of water. Let's come to the third one. Water that seeps into the ground is called groundwater. Option number B. You have to take the option number B, groundwater. Let's come to the fourth one. Which of these do we use to store water? So students, we use bucket, tank and drum to store water. So here our answer will be option number D, that is all of these. Now let's come to the fifth question. The stored water can be used to. So students, the stored water can be used to water plants, clean floors, bath. So here option number D is correct, all of this. Let's come to the question number 6. Drinking dirty water can make us. So students, you know very well, drinking dirty water can make us ill. The seventh one is, how can one kill the germs in drinking water? So students, to kill the germs in drinking water, we have to boil the drinking water. So here option number A, by boiling it, is the correct option. Let's come to the question number C. Give two examples of the following. Now students, here you have to give two examples for the following. The first one is sources of water. So the sources of water is rain and river. You have to fill rain in the first blank and river in the second blank. The second one is things to store water. So we use tank and bucket to store water. You have to fill tank in the first blank and bucket in the second blank. Now the third one is ways to save water. So by making rain storage tank and pond, we can save water. So you have to fill rain storage tank in the first blank and pond in the second blank. Now Your exercise A, B and C is completed now. The remaining exercises of this chapter we will done in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy and stay at your home. Thank you students. Bye and take care.